when the pandemic started, I definitely felt panic. You know, it's really interesting when you have this education in the field that you can actually do something with at a time of crisis like this. I'm glad that the work that we've been able to do in this lab has been directly applied to the field to help improve air quality for students. The things that we do here include looking at how coronavirus persists in the air, how long is it viable in relevant indoor conditions. We also look at how that impacts the ventilation rates we see in the schools. So with that knowledge that we know how to characterize coronavirus in the air, how does that translate to the classroom and what kind of control measures can we implement in those environments?
I knew it was coming. I didn't know when. I didn't know if it was in my lifetime. So in my field, we're trained to think about that. So I was thinking, here it is. This is the one. I was also thinking if there's something that we could do about it. In terms of monitoring, what we're actually doing are putting remote monitors in classrooms that assess one of two things. One is the actual composition of the gases, that is the breath that's accumulating in the classroom or being removed. And then the other is actually monitors that measure and count the very microscopic particles that you can't see that we actually share in close proximity that may or may not contain virus. Even after a pandemic, we're gonna have air quality challenges, both indoors and out. We have urbanization, wildfires, climate change. All these things are coming together to challenge our built environment and the respite where we spend most of our time is indoors. This work is helping us give the schools, parents, community assurance that the air quality is much improved than prior to the pandemic and that risks are substantially reduced.
Being back in the classroom with my kids is amazing. It is amazing how big of a difference it makes to be in person and just kind of get back to a little bit of normalcy. I hope that this research will help other schools and districts realize the importance of having good air quality in schools. Our students are our future, and it's really important that we're breathing in good, healthy, clean air so that they can all be doing their best learning and be living their best lives.